It's been a great experience. On Thursday night, we had a terrible storm roll through here, approximately 5:30, and when the camera starts at 6. So we worshiped in the dark, but it was great. Satan did not control us back. And I'm telling you, through that experience, we realized we need to be prepared. And that's part of what the Haitian Bible School does for us. It prepares us for what life has to offer us. So every evening when we started our school, we began with our pledges. So I will ask you all to stand at this time as the flag stands.
Refreshments served in those classrooms.
Brother Mike, where are you? Mike, did you come to the front of the hall? Brother Mike is our junior high news.
Dear fathers, we dedicate this day, we just want to thank the job of our Lord. We thank you that is a force of that, the blessing to you is, help the hand of the church, your prayers, forefathers, that we just want to be about this money, your prayers. We pray you bless the blessing of that, and you bless the love of you. So Jesus' name we pray.
But to millions is the start of the greatest journey.
need. It's not just you give a box and you walk away. God is using the bridge during the discipleship program, and he's even responding to it.
Jesus said that, do not light a candle and put it on a bushel, to put it so the whole world can see. When a child lights change, it can be.
Allowing us to minister to your children in the name of Jesus. So
Please stand and worship, please.
Thank you.
such thing, but that she should be holy and without blemish. You see, the Lord Jesus loves and cherishes the church. He cares for us. He cares for the church. And we teach and preach the truth. Now, every one of us, including myself, will be presented in the near future things that can keep us out of church. You know, school is starting. The kids may be bombarded with homework on Wednesday nights. There's practices. There's this and that. Weekends is all we have to be together. But I promise you this. The most important thing besides loving your family is to bring your children and your teenagers to church and let them see you worship the Lord Jesus. Let them see you interested in Bible study. And I promise you this, if you put Jesus first, seek ye first the kingdom of God and His righteousness, all them other things will fall into place. I'd like to share with you another passage of Scripture concerning church. By the way, the New Testament is written to the church. It's not written to any club or organization. The New Testament is written to the church of the living Christ. Okay? So, in Hebrews chapter 10, I will find it in my Bible and I'll read it. It'll be on the wall for you. But we'll begin in verse 19 of Hebrews chapter 10. Therefore, brethren, having boldness to enter the holiest by the blood of Jesus, Hebrews is a book about the covenant that we enter in by faith, the blood covenant that Jesus made on the cross. So we can enter in the holiest by the blood of Jesus, by a new and living way, which He consecrated for us through the veil that is His flesh, in having a high priest over the house of God. That high priest is Jesus Christ. He is the head of the church, it says in the letter to the church in Colossae. And so He is our high priest, He is the head of the church over the house of God. Let us draw near with a true heart in full assurance of faith, having our hearts sprinkled from an evil conscience and our bodies washed with pure water. Remember what that pure water is? It's the washing of the Word, as we found out back in Ephesians chapter 5. Listen now, verse 23. Let us hold fast the confession of our hope without wavering, for He who promised is faithful. And let us consider one another in order to stir up love and good works. That's what we're about as a church family. We are to encourage one another, comfort one another, minister to each other and to the world. The shoebox ministry is just one example of the things that the church does. And we use our gifts and talents to do so. Verse 25 is very important. It says, not forsaking the assembly of ourselves together. Now let me ask you this, do you believe this or not? I believe it. And this says, not forsaking the assembly of yourselves together. By the way, Jesus said when two or three are gathered in His name, guess where He'll be? In the midst. He'll be there. So, not forsaking the assembly of ourselves together, as is the manner of some. Let's not be that far, okay? As is the manner of some, but exhorting one another, encouraging one another, praying for one another, loving one another, caring for one another, and so much the more as you see the day approaching. Now this day can mean, it means two things. The Lord's Day, the first day of the week. As you see the day approaching, you know, hey, I'm going to go to worship. I'm going to be with my church family. I'm going to be with my brothers and sisters in Christ. And the day's coming. I'm going to iron my pants. I'm going to get my shirt ready, whatever it takes, and put the world to the side so I can be there and not forsake the assembly of ourselves together. And also that day is the Lord's return. Jesus is coming back. Folks, just look out over the world. Look at our own nation. What is going on? Jesus is coming back. We need to be ready. And we need to be part of the precious New Testament blood-bought church. I have another passage of Scripture, but I'll read that in at the very last this morning. And that is in John chapter 20. But speaking of church, I have top 10 reasons why we don't miss church. You ready? Top 10 reasons. Number 10, snacks in Sunday school. Amen? Number 9, long-lasting friendships. Why is it long-lasting? We're going to spend eternity together. That's long-lasting. By the way, when you say, I'm not going to go to church with them, I've been there. I grew up in a pastor's home, and I saw what things can do in church, how people can act and do this and do that. I've seen it growing up. And I stayed out of church a while because of that, but I have come to realize when I say I'm not going to go with them, in my heart I'm actually mean, I don't want to go and be with Jesus. Because by the way, we are the body of Christ. And when you say, I don't want to go and worship, I don't want to be there, I don't want to see them, I don't want to do that, it's boring to me, you're actually saying, I don't want to go be with Jesus. Did you know that? So, long-lasting friendships with one another. Number 8, singing praises to Jesus. Number 7, hearing a good sermon from the pastor. Not very many amens. Number 6, receiving encouragement from others and giving encouragement to others. Number 5, Bible study. Number 4, praying for one another. Number 3, growing in our faith in Jesus. Number 2, missing makes it easier to miss the next week. Number 1 reason not to miss church. I want to read an example of one. John chapter 20, verse 19. Then the same day at evening, being the first day of the week, when the doors were shut where the disciples were assembled for fear of the Jews, Jesus came. Everyone say, Jesus came.
Jesus came
and stood in the midst and said to them, peace be with you. Jesus spoke peace upon them. When he had said this, he showed them his hands and his side, and the disciples were glad when they saw the Lord. So Jesus said to them again, peace to you. As the Father has sent me, I also send you. See, Jesus came in their presence, spoke peace upon them, and then gave them a commission, something to do. And when he had said this, he breathed on them and said to them, receive the Holy Spirit. If you forgive the sins of any, they are forgiven them. If you retain the sins of any, they are retained. You see, the church has power. Did you know that? When we come together and pray and worship, we have power. God gives us power. Verse 24. Now Thomas, called the twin, one of the 12, was not with them when Jesus came. The other disciples therefore said to him, "We have seen the Lord." So he said to them, "Unless I see in his hands the print of the nails, and put my finger into the print of the nails, and put my hand into his side, I will not believe." Thomas missed out, didn't he? Thomas missed out. He was not present when they were assembled together, and his faith wavered. "Unless I see it myself, I won't believe," he said. Thankfully, Jesus appeared again, and he was there. And he saw the risen Lord, and he fell down before him and said, "My Lord and my God." So the number one reason why we should not want to miss the public assembly of ourselves together, the Bible study and worship, and the preaching of God's Word and the ministry that the church does, you're sure to miss something special that Jesus has for you. You're sure to miss something that Jesus has for you. Now the question this morning is, do you really want to have what Jesus has for you? Do you? You know, I come to church now because there's no other place for me to be. I'm a pastor. You don't think I can do something else? I probably could. But I want to be where Jesus is. Yes, Jesus is in our hearts, and we carry him, and we go out and about. But when we come together as a church, that's where I want to be. I want to be where Jesus is. I want to be where Jesus is high and lifted up. And folks, Jesus has decided that the church is the place where he wants to be high and lifted up. No other place. You may think there's another place, or you may have an idol of your own making and you try to invite God there with your idol. But I tell you what, Jesus decided the church is the place. He loves the church. And he gave his life to the church. Amen? Now, you got to know Jesus personally to really love what he loves. And some of you may not know Jesus as your personal Lord and Savior. He died on the cross for our sins. And so that we can have a relationship with him. Today we sang about it, we worshiped about it, and the gospel message has been presented for every one of us this morning. But if you've never received Christ, I will be here. We're fixing to have an invitation. I will be right here to help you any way I can to pray and ask Jesus in your heart. Maybe you feel led to be part of this church and to worship here and to serve the Lord Jesus as a part of this church. We'll be here to help you any way we can. And during this time also, any one of the children that have received Christ, if it's okay with your parents, you can come forward and we will welcome you and congratulate you for you deciding to be a follower of Jesus Christ the rest of your life. Okay? So, we will attend to this at this time during this invitation. And I want to pray. And then, again, if you feel led in any way to seek Christ, I'll be here to help you any way I can. Let's pray. Lord, again, we thank you for your precious word. And we just thank you, Lord, for allowing us to be part of your church. And Lord, how you love the church. And every letter is written to the church. And even the book of Revelation, it says you hold the church in your very hand. So Lord, we give you praise and thanksgiving. I pray that we'll tend to eternity during this invitation. And Lord, may your Holy Spirit, Lord, have free reign. And I ask it all in your name, Jesus. Amen. Please stand. I'll be right here. Thank you. Lord, be good. And brother, will you come back up here? This young man has come and wants to be part of our church. Brother, I'm sorry, I need to go back and see, but you gotta stay up here with us. He knows Jesus as Lord and Savior, and is moving his letter from the Baptist Church in Virginia to here. He's been biblically baptized. What's your name? Kelsey. Kelsey wants to come be a part of our church. He's been in the church. Everyone say amen.
Amen.
Brother, if you will, just remain up here with everybody else, and we'll welcome you in our church family. Alexis has received Jesus as Lord and Savior. This Gideon also has received Jesus as Lord and Savior and comes for the believer's baptism. And I'm also making it public. Everyone say it loud. This Maya also has received Jesus as Lord and Savior and comes for the believer's baptism. And the church says, we're done.